So hello everyone, myself advocate Gautam Arswal, associate with Dialysi. Welcome to Dialysi. Today in this video I'm going to discuss with you and cover up or remaining part which in the very first part we have already discussed what are the features of Hindu Succession Act. So this is the second part. In this part we are going to complete the our discussion. So let's start the discussion. You know, the starting with the next one, the next feature, the rules of succession are different for the property of males and females. In the case of a male who dies intestate, class 1 heirs are usually given preference over class 2 heirs, and class 2 heirs are further preferred over any other heirs. And the act further abolished the limited estate of woman, and she is now the absolute owner of her property irrespective of its source. Earlier she was a limited owner, and the rights of her property were exercised by her husband. But now all the rights are exercised by her, she can even dispose of her property and take decisions. The next one is the act also recognizes the the right of a child in the property who is in the mother's womb, which is basically described under section 20 of the act. It states that an unborn child in a woman's womb would have the right to inherit the property, assuming that he has been born before a person dies intestate. The act also clarifies that full blood relations are preferred over half blood relations under section 18 of the act, and it further explains the concept of shares that are to be divided per capita or per stipe. A division of shares in which a share is given to a branch of heirs as a whole, and such heirs inherit property or as tenants in common under section 19 of the act. And the last one is it gives a list of people that are excluded from inheriting a property on different grounds. However, it abolished all the grounds that excluded a person due to his physical deformity or capability under section 28 of the act. It also provides that the right of an illegitimate child to inherit property is confined to the mother's property and not the father's property. So I hope you're pretty much clear with the facts. In case of any doubt, any confusion, do let me know in the comment section. See you on the next video with some more information.